All right, so we're back here, and we actually have Luke this week. So that's
I'm back.
yeah,
I'm
he's
back from the ancient. I'm back from the ancient civilization. My planet needed me.
yeah, he was doing stuff. I think that's what we kept saying. He was doing important stuff every episode or something. I
Yeah,
don't
I mean it was ta I guess it's taboo what I was doing, so
it's really secretive. Yeah, it's called moving.
it's a pretty, not so common thing in this world, because that never, it's very rare.
No,
Nobody
yeah.
moves. Mm-mm.
No. Especially when you're a college kid. No,
No,
no one ever moves.
no.
No.
Nope.
Ever.
But yeah, I mean, I guess we can just start off just kind of talking and stuff. But I gotta tell you guys what happened to me. I was on a set this past
Scoop.
weekend, and yeah, it's a little scoop, I guess, behind the scenes thing. You get to know a little bit about me. I went on a set, and okay, it was the first day I get there. I'm like talking to the director. He's like, "Oh, can you help out this dude set up the stuff, like the props and all that?" So I walk over. He gives me like a staple gun. He's like, "Can you help me staple this thing onto a wall?" I'm like, "Sure." So I have the staple gun, right? I have it pointed backwards, which I don't realize. And I pull the trigger on it. I shoot it, the staple, and I feel like I felt like something weird in my hand. And it turns out I stapled my thumb, and it was this is I'm this is a big ass stapler too. This is not a little tiny. This is a massive
If
staple
you could see
gun.
my face right now. Ooh.
And it went. It was clean through my thumb. You can see the dude had to get pliers and pull it out right in front of me. No, no painkiller, nothing. Just pulled it right out. The first thought that ran through my head was, am I going to be able to get this out? Am I screwed? Am I going to die right now?
If I could die.
But no, it all worked out. It didn't hurt that much. There was blood and stuff, but it wasn't too bad. I was able to continue working the rest of the 12 hours that day, but yeah. That was my war story that happened 1 hour into the first day on my set.
Ta-da!
So yeah,
Showtime, break a leg.
that happened.
A king bears his scars for all the world to see.
Oh my god.
I just started watching Game of Thrones, so.
Yeah,
Ooh, a
you're in
crown
for a
for a
lot of
king.
stuff.
A crown for a king is all I gotta say.
A crown made of staples.
No,
Oh
no,
my
no, no,
god.
no, 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 no. You know what I'm talking about, right?
No, I know what you're talking about. I know. I know.
A crown for a king. Ooh. Aquaman. Like, that's. Ooh. Okay.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Now I know.
Yeah. Okay. Anyways, back to DC.
No, I mean, well, I mean,
Or yeah, your story. Yeah, your
yeah,
story.
We were going to transition. I mean, what have you guys been up to in your own day-to-day
Neck of the
activities?
woods.
Moving. It's been such a so okay, so the reason I haven't been able to be part of the Super Friends, again, I've been moving, but I've been finished for like 3 weeks. The only reason I haven't been part of the episodes is because my internet provider, who will not be named, freaking is the biggest bunch of incompetent idiots on the planet, and I couldn't get anything done for a while. So hopefully it's going to be resolved by next week. I am currently recording this in my little bed at my mammy and pappy's house.
No shame, no shame.
No shame here. So yeah, that's what I've been doing. I mean, I've also been busy doing other stuff. I've been, writing a bunch and all that, but nothing of importance to the reason why I'm not part of the podcast for a while. The reason why CJ and Josh had to cover my ass.
Yeah, but that's Yeah, that's what's been going on with Luke, though. McKinley, though, has been doing some interesting stuff, too.
Very, very, very interesting things.
Can go into that, I guess.
I guess you can say I also had a moving story. Mine only lasted a day and then transitioned into college life. And college life is very enjoyable, to say the least. So that's basically what all I've been doing. It's actually, That's actually why we're recording this pretty late, because we all had some issues and couldn't all meet up. So again, apologize for that, but we're still doing it.
We're recording this Friday night, and it'll probably be up Saturday, maybe. I mean, depending on how long. I'll probably edit it overnight, but yeah, it'll be up soon. I'm sure everyone is wondering, where's the Super Friends at?
Yes, I'm sure that's what everyone's been saying.
Clearly, that's the thing. Everybody has been waiting for this new episode, but
with bated breath for the Super Friends.
Yeah,
the hype is real.
But yeah, oh, I also wanted to tell you guys too. On the short that I was on the set, we had a really high profile actor on board the project, and it's actually the guy. I don't know if you guys played Call of Duty Black Ops. If you either of you played that.
I played it.
No. The first or have you guys played either both of them or just like the first one?
I've played both. I don't know if I really paid attention to the story all that much because I really don't care. But
yeah, no, the character that's Frank Woods, like Sergeant Woods in the Black Ops. Okay. Yeah, his voice actor was one of the actors on the. He's a really, really cool guy. We talked a lot about stuff like, you know, off camera, like during downtime. We just talked about like what he's doing. He's making a movie called Nazi Zombies, actually, which is pretty much gonna be like, you know, Nazi zombies. But he's got like a $30 million budget for it and shit. So it's
damn,
it's gonna be pretty cool. And yeah, so that was another highlight, I guess, of the weekend. But yeah, I guess we can kind of just move into the DC news here. We got a pretty big story to start off with. So this came out, I think, a couple weeks ago. Heroic Hollywood, El Mayimbo, was talking about this. He kept saying it was unconfirmed, it's just like a rumor, but John Schnepp actually went on to the DC movie news show, I believe it was yesterday, and talked a little bit about it too. And he seemed pretty confident when he was talking about it, but basically it's that George Miller is being tapped to direct the Man of Steel, like, Superman sequel. So, I guess, what are your thoughts on that?
Awesome.
I was expecting a sloshing noise from McKinley, but, I really like this idea. You take it also into the fact that George Miller was supposed to direct Justice League Mortal back in 2008. It's just kind of cool to see that he's going to be coming back into DC and that he's doing Superman, like a Man of Steel sequel. That's really interesting to see.
Very, very. Wait, so were you expecting a little bit of... Because there it is. But, yeah.
And a lot of people were expecting New Gods, though, right? Like, they're like, oh, yeah, New Gods, he's, like, rumored or something. And they're like, no.
I didn't think New Gods, but I figured he was going to come back to DC. Didn't know when. He just wanted to get a couple projects out, you know, with that Mad Max and all that.
But, yeah. Now that you think about it, New Gods from George Miller would have been amazing. Mm-hmm. But, you know, maybe he could even... Maybe New Gods could even be referenced in Superman. I mean, I know that they didn't start.
Or Wonder Woman too. Wonder Woman too with Orion.
Yeah, yeah. What if Tom Hardy was Orion?
I could see
that. Would be sick.
Amazing.
That would be sick. But
now
dude.
He's.
Then you could build up Darkseid from there.
Yeah, but now no, he's 100 bullets. So
now he has 100 bullets in him. So yeah.
To be fair, I've heard that's a cool graphic novel. I haven't read it.
But. Yeah, I think it'll be cool. It's just like a guy. It's kind of a shame that he's not working in the DC universe properly.
As far as we know.
Yeah. But, well, so I mean, have we all seen Mad Max Fury Road?
No.
I saw it twice. I loved it.
So, McKinley, it's amazing. You should go see it. I don't know why you haven't yet.
I've heard many good things about it. I read the little comic tie-in. That's about it. And I haven't watched any of the other Mad Maxes, so it was like a completely new thing for me. But yeah. I've heard many good things, so I'll check it out. It's on my list.
Yeah. So, I mean... That guy coming to Superman, I mean, I don't even know what he could possibly do with it. All I know is just that, I don't know, I just really like the idea. It's definitely going to be really, it'll be visually interesting, probably even more visually interesting than something Zack Snyder would have done with a sequel.
It'd probably have the visual of, like, Zack Snyder, like, that he showed us that we can do with Superman. But seeing how, of course, I'm hearing all these good things about Mad Max Fury Road, he'll have a better story, is what I'm hoping for.
Yeah.
Something more deeper than just a origin story with a little twist, but
it's interesting.
We'll actually have Superman now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's interesting that Miller has like directed like Happy Feet and Babe Pig in the City too, like among other things. So
like, I forgot about that.
We know he can do like any type of movie, basically. I mean,
yeah, pretty much. So I mean. here's hoping Superman will actually be hopeful in a Man of Steel sequel.
Debatable.
Mm-hmm. I think it's interesting too because George Miller has a lot of the same visual cues and styles and like the way he handles action, kind of like Zack Snyder anyways too, when you look at their movies and stuff like Mad Max and then like Watchmen and all that kind of stuff.
Didn't like, Mad Max have like a lot of practical effects?
Yeah,
that's what I heard. That could be cool.
Expect Metallo to be made out of completely practical effects.
Oh, that'd be interesting. Looking like Smallville.
She use a Brainiac for the movie. That'd be cool.
Ooh, that would be actually kind of cool. Brainiac.
Just bring back that spider thing. Superman lives.
No, Lexiac. We got to push Lexiac for SummerSlam.
Brainiac. God.
Yep. What we're saying is that this would be really cool if it's true.
Yes.
Yeah, we probably wouldn't even see it anyway. It's like 2019 or something, like way like in the future anyway, so.
Yeah, probably. Hopefully not. Hopefully before 2020 though.
Most definitely.
When George Miller will be like 75 years old directing this movie. not in a wheelchair though, like running around like a 30-year-old director. Like
no, he's got like the Immortan Joe mask on to kind of help his breathing while he's directing.
Yeah, but I guess it's overall we're pretty positive on it. Let us know down below what you guys think about George Miller. We think he'll be awesome. But yeah, the next piece of news here that we have is that Warner Brothers held a private screening of Batman vs. Superman. Well, apparently a few screenings because Kevin Sugihara talked about it. He's like, yeah, I've seen the movie a few times now. And apparently got like a standing ovation. Everyone's like going crazy about it. They're giving Ben Affleck a trilogy of Batman movies because they're so impressed by the take on his character. So, what do you guys think about this news?
Anything that like gets more positivity towards BVS.
Just
the fact that like executives are like clapping for it and everything, like, you know, that's cool that they're confident or that they just loved it and everything. Again, you know, I mean, it's positive for BVS. I don't really know what else to say. Doesn't really make me any more excited. I was already pretty excited for it to begin with.
I like how they talked about it on Heroes and they were like, oh, so the studio is praising their own movie? I'm shocked. Like, but yeah.
Wait, who said that? Was that John Campia?
Yeah, it was John Campia. Well, I mean, they all talked about it like that. Like, well, really? I wouldn't think the studio would support their own movie. But yeah, I mean, it's not anything to be surprised about, but it's nothing bad to hear. It's good to hear that.
Yeah, but this just makes me more jealous of like people like that. Like Kevin Sugihara, he's been like, yeah, I've seen it like a few times already. He's like, what? Can I see it now?
Right.
Can I sneak in? Did you guys talk about the whole thing where like Batman was supposedly supposed to be the cornerstone of the DC universe? Because that was kind of with this news when they were talking about the standing ovation stuff.
Oh yeah, the new Robert Downey Jr. Tony Stark role.
Yeah. Did you guys ever cover that on the other episodes?
Uh-uh. No, I don't think we talked about it yet. Yeah.
Well, I think that happened like after we recorded. So and then we didn't do this. Okay. So yeah. So now we're getting to it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, like the whole thing is like there's a standing ovation. Everyone's like praising Ben Affleck's Batman. So the plan apparently right now is that he's going to be like the cornerstone of the DC extended universe, I guess we're being forced to call it.
I could see him being like the Robert Downey Jr. / Nick Fury role because, I mean, he's popping up in Suicide Squad. Who says he's not going to pop up in the other movies? Right, and of course, since the rumor is that he will be gathering the Justice League members, I wouldn't be surprised if that's what's going on.
Yeah.
I think they said that Wonder Woman is the one that makes the Justice League.
In that script. Yeah. Or, you know, she like helps put them together. I don't know about. Well, yeah, the script did say that because Aquaman, yada, yeah.
Aquaman popped in and said, I'll help you. And then he's like, all right, I'll be a part of your team later. And then he leaves.
Because Batman would be like, I don't care about being a part of any of you. He'd like leave.
Yeah.
I'm Batman.
Yeah. No, it would be funny just the idea that Batman's creating the Justice League for the sole purpose of keeping them all in one place so he can study them and everything.
Yeah.
I mean, he would do that. Would. I mean, think about it. Freaking Justice League 2 is like a basically Tower of Babel story.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that would be interesting.
It's going to be so weird. It's going to be so weird, too, seeing a universe like where these characters interact too. We've never seen like Batman interact with we've never seen any of these characters interact together. They've all been separate.
Yeah.
And especially most of these characters have never been on any other live action interpretation, which is also incredible.
Yeah,
this is literally an eye opener. Wow, this is our the general audience's first taste of all these characters. Like I have never experienced really.
Yeah, like, I mean, this is going to be the first time we're ever going to see Flash on, like, the big screen or Wonder Woman and stuff. It's really, it's going to be cool, just the whole idea that, they're going to really try their hardest to try to have some sort of connective tissue between these movies.
Yeah, I remember when The Dark Knight came out, like, in 2008, I was like, man, I can't wait. Like, I really hope they do a Justice League movie one day. Like, I hope they all come together in, like, a movie.
Yeah. I mean, we were close, but, you know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe I didn't want to see that version.
even to this day, I still want to see that movie. And I want to see that documentary that's being made for it.
I'll watch that documentary, but maybe not.
No, they are making it. You know that?
Yeah. Well, yeah, like apparently there's like a hiccup or something because they need to get approval from Warner Brothers to use the concept art and footage and... But
right. They've shown a little bit of it, like you saw, like that Martian Manhunter mask.
Yeah. Well, because there's God. Like top secret stuff, like they never shown the Batman costume and like Superman and all that.
Which was supposed to be like the best things. Like they're like the most comic accurate interpretations of like all those big amazing things we've heard about it. Then it just done.
Didn't Army Hammer say he actually wore it?
Yeah,
they all did. Yeah.
Really? Mm-hmm. Wow.
Army Hammer was Batman. DJ Katrona. I don't know who that guy was, but he was Superman.
Yeah, Megan Gale or something.
And,
Woman.
As Wonder Woman. And she like looking at her now. Like I saw. Like man, that she really could. She has that physique. She could have been a good Wonder Woman.
Yeah.
Common was Green Lantern or something.
John Stewart. They're basically doing the animated series is what they were doing. I take that back. It wasn't the anime series. It was like the current run of the Justice League at the time. Except without Wally, they would have had Barry.
Yeah.
Right.
No, but it's going back though to the whole BVS screening. I can't wait to see more of the movie. Like I said, just any time I hear about the movie now, I'm just like, man, I want to see it now. Like. Mm-hmm. Like we've almost seen it, we know like pretty much almost everything about it, like vaguely. But
yeah, vaguely. We don't have the exact details, but we have a picture of it, an outline.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know, guys. I mean, March just can't get here fast enough.
Mm-hmm. Nope.
No, 7 more months or something. I think.
Don't tell me that number.
And we'll get another trailer. I'm assuming we'll get another trailer with Star Wars like December time. Ooh. Because that would be probably the best place to put it, I think.
Maybe around that time.
That's when the countdown for all these movies are going to start, basically.
Yeah. I keep forgetting Star Wars comes out this year. But anyway.
So many things are coming out. That's for the next podcast.
That's for the...
Coming soon, Star Wars
podcast. Guest starring on Jedi Council. No, not really. But,
not Jedi Council, no.
Ew.
Everything I like.
What is that?
Everything
is that crap?
Everything I like.
Let's not make enemies with Collider here, guys.
No.
Oh, screw Collider.
I love you. I love you, people.
I hate them.
All right, let's move on.
Yeah, let's move on. Okay, yeah. So Heroic Hollywood, he dropped another big old scoop. He was hyping it up, like, oh yeah, he's like, it's like a huge scoop. Like I like Umberto and everything, but like sometimes he hypes up like nothing, and this is like one of those times where it's kind of like, okay, we more or less knew this was going to happen in the movie. Basically, he's saying that Wonder Woman is going to have, like, a standalone fight with Doomsday, and I think we could see part of it in the trailer when she gets, like, pushed along into that pillar thing.
Yeah,
that's basically what's happening, so tell me your guys' thoughts on that.
Yeah, I mean, no duh. Like,
it's like, this is exclusive, guys. I know sourcing. It's like, okay.
Yeah. I mean, Doomsday has been all but confirmed for freaking BVS by this point. And if you're going to put Doomsday, you're going to have the heroes fighting him. So, you know, there you go. Great scoop.
We can only assume they would fight, you know, because you're not just going to have Doomsday and him not
fight.
They
gotta have Batman fight Doomsday too, without it, like, in his normal costume, like, just fighting, punching him.
And yeah, that'll be a quick fight.
I want to see him punch him and just break his hand, and then, like, oh, backup plan, new bat suit out of nowhere. Batman.
I can't beat him by punching.
I must think my way.
I
want
to see Batman riding on Superman's back, like, as they fly into
him. Oh, no, you could totally have, like, one of those scenes where Superman picks him up by his arms and Batman's just pissed off. It's like, I don't like you holding me like this.
He's got, like, the grumpy cat face.
All that pride.
Yeah. Well, I mean, a lot of people speculated, too, in the BVS trailer when... Because they kind of cut it together cleverly where you see Superman flying in using the heat vision and then it cuts to Batman, like, jumping out of the way. But the heat vision, like, the blast looks way bigger than Superman's. So people are saying, like, does Doomsday have heat vision in this version?
It would make sense if it's supposed to be, like, from Zod's body and it's Kryptonian.
Yeah,
but even going back to just Doomsday's origin in the comics, which is very convoluted and could be very hard to adapt on screen. Yeah. He was supposed to be. He wasn't Kryptonian. He was like another alien, and then it got mixed with a Kryptonian.
Yeah.
But it makes sense.
Yeah, I'm just saying. To be fair, no one's really up in arms about Doomsday's origin because no one really cares about Doomsday in the sense of being a character. Yeah. He's kind of just there.
It's cool
as a plot device.
It's cool, but it's not. It's not that serious. It's not that serious.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, like, don't get me wrong. It's a really cool origin, like being like just dying multiple times on like freaking back then Krypton, but I mean no one really cares, so yeah.
It's one of those, hey, I read comics, let's have a debate, and I'm gonna pull that out of my ass, but you're not that's again very hard to adapt that on screen and it be believable in this grounded world that they're setting up.
Yeah, that there's so many different survivors from Krypton.
Yeah, because we just need more prequel scenes of Krypton, guys. We need 30 minutes in this movie.
We need more dragonfly creatures, but
I don't get the people that are saying that Doomsday requires his own film either, because that's just stupid. Like, who wants to see 2 hours of just this killing machine that does nothing?
Well, honestly,
you mean like Doomsday, like as a solo film of Doomsday?
No, like a Death of Superman, where it's just like Superman versus Doomsday, like the whole movie is like the only villain.
Ew.
No, because like, going, if it was, that'd be too short. Because, like, if you go by the comic, it's really not that long.
Yeah, like, the whole Doomsday fight, like, it doesn't even last that long. It's like a...
It's like a good four issues.
Yeah, and I mean, he kills him, and then that's it. Like, that's all. After that, Doomsday becomes, like, a total chump.
The only way you can make it cool is, like, how I think that if they were to do that... You would have to end the movie with that. You wouldn't make the movie about that. Like, you would have to have him fight the Justice League and beat them, and then Superman has to cliche come by and have to beat him, and they both die, and then you end it, and then you come back with the return of Superman in like an I forgot what the arc is called. Something Friends, Funeral for a Friend type movie, which
just,
is really
just
cool.
Go watch Josh's screenplay on Death.
Yeah.
Just go look at those up. Hyper Network plug right there. Go watch Josh's DC screenplay. No, okay, yeah.
I'll go ahead and say this: Justice League Animated had the best Death of Superman story, and Doomsday was nowhere to be found in it.
Yeah, but it's cool though. Another thing that we can bring up too is the whole Michael Shannon having the flipper hands on set. That kind of like sort of ties into Doomsday, like being in the movie. Maybe he's like, people are speculating that he's coming back to play like a CGI Doomsday, just like the flipper things, like for like a like reference or something. You know, the digital effects artists such as like they have big green hands for like the thing, whatever. But
see, when I saw that, I thought of a joke, because whenever, I think it was one of the interviews, he was talking about like, if you could fight any other superhero besides Superman, who would you fight? And he said Aquaman. So I'm like, oh, he's gonna fight him as like a flipper fish Black Manta.
Yeah, he's King Shark. Yeah.
Yeah, King Shark. Yeah.
He was wearing an Aquaman shirt at like some like cinema fest like last year when Jason Momoa was there too.
Yeah, yeah.
He had an Aquaman shirt on. I was like, what?
You heard it here, folks. This is the scoop of the century.
Zod the Aquaman.
Michael Shannon's King Shark, but no. Doomsday and BVS makes sense. It's not going to be like a huge thing. I don't know why he needs a whole movie to build up to it and all that. But no. But yeah, going back to the original story, Wonder Woman versus Doomsday. That's also pretty obvious. I mean. It's not like she's just going to be there and just, like, stand around and do nothing. And
yeah.
You know, yeah.
But, yeah.
I mean, we would hope she's not, but it looks like she has some stuff to do.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. And she looks pretty darn good in the costume, too, in the two shots that we saw in the trailer. So.
Yeah. I mean, we know that she gives Doomsday that whole freaking mean girl look, so.
Yeah, and
you pushed me against that motherfucking wall.
Oh, hell no. Oh.
She starts undoing her Wonder Weave.
The last of the truth in the Wonder Weave.
Yeah, apparently in that one scene in the trailer where she puts her gauntlets together and there's a huge explosion, apparently that's like her blocking a rocket.
Oh.
Because, yeah, like some... I can't remember where I read it. Like some guy said like, oh yeah, I've known about that scene for a while or something. He's like, yeah, it's called like a rocket punch or something. Like some rocket flies at her or something.
Rocket puncher!
Fucking yeah, punch! So
that'll be kind of cool to see, I guess. Like her using the gauntlets or whatever, the bracelets.
Yeah. But, I mean, a rocket's kind of a big payload. It's a little bit bigger than a bullet, but, you know.
Just a tad.
Yeah. Yeah, but I guess we should probably move on to the last piece of news that we have here, which is... kind of in the TV realm of things, that this is surprising to me, just the premise of the show and the network that it's coming to, because this is a show coming to NBC and it's another DC Comics kind of property, and you know, after the whole fallout of Constantine, I thought there would be like bad blood between them, they wouldn't want to work together on another thing, but apparently they're developing a show called Powerless. And it focuses on average people in the DC universe, and it's supposed to be like The Office or something. So
yeah.
It's like, okay, yeah, that's happening.
This is dumb. This is the dumbest idea I've ever heard.
Yeah. See, I had no idea what it was until y'all explained it to me. And my first reaction, I told them, I was like, "I'm gonna bring this up. Why would you trust them again?" If they just did the way they did Constantine. I was like, I want to see what slot they give them, because if it's better than Constantine's, I'm going to be pissed. Like,
well, I mean, they're not trusting them with a specific hero. They're trusting them with normal people with heroes in the background, so I guess it's fine, but I mean...
still, I'm just like, really? Really? Now you're going to do that? I mean, I'm not going to say I'm not going to watch it, because I'm totally going to check it out.
I'm not. This
yeah, show. It would, chance, and then y'all
it would
hate
be,
on it.
It'd be funny like, if they already... put it on Monday nights, so I had to compete against Supergirl and Gotham. Like, all three of them were on Monday night.
Oh my gosh.
This is an idea worth pitting against the others. But, oh my god, freaking... Like, this is just... I don't know. I have a couple things with this. First of all, I already have an office. I don't need a freaking copycat. Second of all... So, the basic premise is normal people living in a world with superheroes. I mean, that's fine and all, but at the same time, like, what's the whole premise? It's just going to be normal jokes. Maybe someone throws in, like, oh, did you see that big Superman fight? That was really cool. Maybe a car gets thrown into their building. They have to move somewhere else. Bing, bang, boom. That's it.
It also comes in, like, how are you going to, like, not show the heroes? Like, I mean, because eventually, like, it'll get annoying and you'll want to see them because they'll be referenced so much. Like, where are they going to be living? Are they going to be living in, like, Metropolis or Gotham or something like that? Or?
Yeah. I mean, they'll show heroes. They're going to be the most C-list characters. You can just imagine freaking Ambush Bug is going to appear on this show. And it's going to be just... He's going to be in the background.
He's
going to
be the news reporter. on their TV.
Yes, he'll be the news reporter.
No, we'll get booster gold on this show, but nothing else. Watch.
Oh.
You'll have a non-speaking.
No, it'll only be good if they're like, "Oh, look, it's Green Lantern." Like that'll only make it good. Like.
I guess. I don't know.
You know what would be good though, if they took this show in the direction of like Seinfeld or something, like not try to be like The Office, but like more like Seinfeld or something. Like.
Yeah.
I mean, my whole thing, because I was talking about this with a couple buddies of mine, freaking the whole thing is just that you could have done something different where you could have made a comedy about like people that were. You could have done this whole comedy about how some superheroes try to keep their secret identity in like normal situations. You could have had like a very, you could have even just made up characters and just had like parodies of superheroes, and that would have been fine. Instead of we're going to be spoon-fed a bunch of C-list characters that are going to have like non-speaking cameos, or someone's going to be like, "Look, they're Superman." We're going to have CGI Rubber Man flying through the air.
Or they could have done. And this is just like something like sort of in the same vein, I guess. It could be a comedy, but like have actual like DC characters. And recently, Convergence had like the JSA tie-in. I think it was JSA or JLA, where it had like the kind of D-listers on it. It had like Elongated Man and like
it was
other
JLA.
Characters like that.
It was
JLA. Yeah, that one. Yeah, if they had a show like with a D-list like team of heroes like that, where it was like more comedy based because they were kind of like wacky and like not as professional as the Justice League, you know?
Yeah, I mean, you could have definitely done the whole still thing with like The Office, where it's like a TV crew is like following them, and it's like basically they're just talking like, "Yeah, I stretch." I mean, I do other stuff too. I'm like a detective.
Yeah,
and everything,
they could have used
mean,
like characters like Plastic Man and all that kind of like.
I
want to
see Elongated
characters.
Man with his nose twitch. Yeah, that'd be awesome.
And I mean, like if you had Booster Gold on the show, it would have made perfect sense why there was a TV crew and everything.
Yeah, it shows the cleanup of every fight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, going back to the whole Powerless though, I'm not entirely opposed to the show. I'm probably gonna watch it just to see if it's any good, but it just depends on how they do it, because they have had success with the comedies. I mean, they had Friends, they had Seinfeld, they had Big Bang Theory. They have tons. Warner Brothers is like a ton of good comedy like shows that are like really highly rated and everything. But
right,
it just I don't know. A lot is hinging on it to be good. Hopefully, but you know, it depends. I don't know.
I would argue nothing's hinging on it. No one cares.
I care.
Luke's boycotting this right now. I do not care. Take it off the air. Bring Constantine back. Yes.
No, just put Constantine on the other CW shows. Just have him a recurring character.
Yes, a CW Constantine show. That will do great, Nick. That'll be the greatest thing we've ever seen. A more watered down version of Constantine.
Well, I don't think he'd be watered down. I honestly think he'd have a better portrayal. I mean, we see how Supernatural was doing.
Yeah.
It's like, yes, we also see all the romantic love triangles inside Supernatural as well. I want to see a love triangle between John, Zed, and Chaz. Aww. Do it now.
Aww. Oh no, because Chaz is married, bro. He's married. Oh no, he's not married.
He's divorced.
He's divorced with his daughter. You're right.
You lose this round.
Now we got to see Manny, John, and Zed.
Yeah.
I did like Manny though. Manny cracked me up.
The Spectre will come in and be like, "Constantine, that was totally my girl, bro. How could you do that to me?"
Yeah, because the angel's gonna be doing that. I really liked the episode did you watch all of it? I really loved the episode where he got John put him in a body and he had all those experiences. Cracked me up. Whenever he went to the restroom, or not the restroom, the office with that nurse, and he was like, "Oh Lord."
I love the episode where there's a really big cliffhanger that's never gonna get addressed.
Oh yeah, it's
like,
not even,
yeah, we'll see you next season.
Yeah,
like, nope, never.
He's like, "Oh, we got rid of the darkness."
How are they gonna explain
really
that
explained.
Though? How are they gonna explain that when he appears on Arrow? How are they gonna be like, "Oh, where'd you come from?" Like, I don't know.
You know what? Wait. I gotta say something real quick, because. I think y'all know I love the multiverse. Like, Crisis on Infinite Earths is still my favorite story all day. John Constantine has this whole role in there where he's aware of the multiverse. Like, he knows all about it. So you could easily have it. He shows up. It's like, yeah, my old world got canceled, so I came to this one.
Maybe. Another way I was just now thinking of, we don't really know what time that show takes place either. So you could put that anywhere. You could have that be like right before Vandal Savage's stuff starts. And then from there what's his name? The Time Master who's going to be on this.
Rip Hunter.
He could meet up with Rip Hunter in like where he's from, their European place. And then he East brings London, him in there. They can go meet up in East London and then go bring back Sarah.
they can exchange insults and all that.
Cigarettes.
That's all assuming if the Bullocks. Constantine show is actually going to be canon to the CW stuff. Mm-hmm.
Just awesome.
Yeah. But going back to Powerless though, I don't even know when that show like comes out either. They've given very vague details because I think they just announced it like a couple days ago too. So
I hope it's never.
See, it was actually apparently it was when I looked it up after you told me, it was brought up on the August 12th. So obviously it's not being talked about too well. So I didn't hear about it till you told me about it.
Yeah. So Constantine died, so Powerless can live.
Just let that stew inside you guys.
Yeah.
Just think about that.
Yeah, so that was basically the show this week. That's pretty much all the news. Luke and McKinley didn't get a chance to read over comics that came out this week, but I'm just going to briefly say, Dark Side War is pretty good so far. Check it out.
Ooh, that was this week?
Yeah, it just came
Ooh,
out.
Ooh, I'm hype.
Just sleep 40.
I'm hype.
I'm going to steal my parents' internet so that I can read Darkseid.
Ooh, I'm hype now. I'm hype. Okay, I got to read that. I want to see Batman. Bat God. I want to see it. I'm ready.
Batron, you mean.
Batron. Bat God. God of the Batrons. I don't know. But yeah.
Yeah, so again, if you guys want to have your questions answered, we're going to give a one-word answer like I did last time. It's no. make sure you leave them down in the comments below or tweet at the Hybrid Network Twitter account using the hashtag, I believe it's hashtag Superfriends Podcast.
Yes, or hashtag, hashtag Superfriends Podcast, not hashtag SF Podcast. Because after saying that, we happened to look and see that there was an entirely other podcast that uses that. So don't do that.
Yeah, just tweet at us using that hashtag or leave a comment down below and, maybe we'll answer it next week, or probably not, though. But we're gonna skim over them. Yeah, no, we'll answer them. But we'll see you guys next time.
Peace.
All right, peace.